I want to speak today about room modes and how they impact our music. I mean, we've talked a lot technically about what a room mode is. It's pressure that doesn't like the physical dimensions in which the area it's trying to fit. It's like trying to squeeze into your jeans that you had when you were in college. It's just not going to work. Or it's someone who's a size 4 or size 8 dress trying to squeeze into a size 4. So things just don't fit. When they don't fit, then we get resonances, at least in room acoustics. The clothing example, other things happen. But the bottom line here is, let's talk about how room modes impact our music. We've all heard these things and maybe just don't know what they are. So today we're going to talk a little bit about that. Let's take drums. The bass drum can go all the way down to 40 cycles. But let's forget about the technical side of it for now and just talk about the music. When the kick drum is kicked by the drummer and a snare or a tom is struck at the same time, what happens? Well, the energy from the bass drum goes out into the room, and since it's the lowest frequency, it excites our room modes. Well, those room modes may not be friendly to the frequencies or sounds of our snare or tom. So we hear the big energy from the bass drum, but we don't hear the smaller, if you will, energy from the snare or the tom. And that's the blurring and the smearing we talk about with room modes. And you may not even know you're missing that unless you can actually see the performer striking the drum, the snare or the tom, and the bass. So if you don't see that sequence or synchronicity, you may not even realize that the note's been played. That's how powerful room modes are. Attack and decay. If the bass drum is going to be able to live out sort of its life in terms of sound into the room, then it has a particular time frame that 40 cycle wave lasts. Well, if it lasts too long in the room because of the resonance of the room, because of the physical dimensions of the room and the energy levels that we're playing at, then our snares and tom just don't stand a chance. So we get a real sloppy attack and decay. It's a blurring, it's a smearing. There's not detail. Each note struck by each instrument must be able to live out its acoustical life, if you will, in the room without being destroyed by the room itself. Here's another good example, bass guitar. When a bass guitar player plays that low E string and then goes to the A, the next string, you've got to be able to hear the beginning of the E, the life, if you will, of the E, and then the end or the decay of the E. So there's three parts to that one strike. Most rooms won't let you hear that. Most rooms, because what's the E string on a bass guitar is what, 30 cycles. So most rooms would not let you hear that because the attack of the bass goes out into the room and interacts with the room, and then the room kind of interjects its own stink, if you will, into the sound, so we don't get a good decay rate. So we may hear the attack, but not the decay. Now when the next E note is hit, if the last E note is still in the room, now we've got two energy sources creating for the same space. We have the room and the speaker. Not good. How about drums, bass, vocals? Oh, I mean, this is a constant battle in rooms. All our emotional content is in our vocals. But if our bass and our bass guitar and our bass drum are not cooperating with our room, our vocals will be smeared and blurred to the point where there's things we can't even hear. If you want to test this out, listen to the same song in your car versus your listening room or control or monitoring room. There's so many reflections in your car off glass, yikes, that, you know, there's parts of the vocal you won't hear, but in your room, because you have more space, more volume, and hopefully better acoustical treatment than your car, then, you know, you'll be able to hear these differences. But our emotional connection to the musician, our emotional connection to the music, is hearing everything. And we have a responsibility, I believe, when we listen to a musician's music, to get everything he's put into that, because every note is important to him. My God, I've seen musicians spend months just getting one vocal track right. So we owe it to the musicians to treat our rooms in a way that lets us hear everything that's being played. Thank you. I hope this helps.